met? We met.
Well, we actually met on a website called MySpace, and the reason we started talking was because she had a really cute picture of her cat up, and Mauser.
Yes.
And I just sent her a message saying, "Cool cat," or "Nice cat," or "Cute cat," or something like that.
And we love animals, and.
And we started talking, and actually just pretty much sent jokes back and forth to each other all the time. Talked a bunch, and then our first actual in-person meeting was we met for drinks at Savoy's, a bar near us.
Gin and tonic all over my bag, and that was...
Yeah, and I actually don't even think she was 21 at that point, so, you know, she was...
I was 20.
In a bar illegally, it was fun. But yeah, that's how we met.
What don't I love about this guy? I don't know, he's awesome. He's caring and supportive, and I love that he's my best friend. I want to marry my best friend. That sounds like a good idea, so. Yeah, that's what I love.
I love everything about her. She's fun. I really have a good time when I'm with her all the time, and that's really important. Like, even when we fight, we still love each other. It doesn't matter. You know, we get through everything. We have a ton of fun together. We travel together. We love the same things for the most part. We have a lot of differences also, but who doesn't? And we both love our dogs. We love our cats, and you know, I just love everything about her. I love the way she is with our. You know, with our animals and stuff, she's so cute with them, and I don't know. I just love everything about her.
Have a good life.
Yeah, I think we're gonna have a good life. I think not even I don't like about her, but she just stresses out a lot, and I think she really needs me because I don't stress out very much, so I'm the one to kind of keep my cool when she gets all worked up. But you know. Like yesterday when we got here, things were an absolute disaster, but I kept it cool, you know, but we got everything taken control. Everything got taken control of, or taken care of, rather. Sorry, I can't talk.
Is this what you like about yourself, or is this what you like about me? You don't like about me? I don't know.
It's not that I don't like about it. I said I don't have anything I don't like about you.
First thing I thought.
Nice hair.
Nice surfer hair. No, that's not. I really felt like I already knew you. I felt like I've known him for a long time. And you're my friend first. That's how I felt.
I felt kind of the same thing when we first met, actually in person the first time. It really wasn't like a awkward, like, first date kind of thing. Like, I feel like I already knew her because we had talked so much online, and we really kind of knew everything about each other before we even met, so it was I guess that made it so much easier for us to just kind of go with the flow, like, right away. I mean, you know, she broke the ice real well by spilling her drink all over, so, you know, that always kind of helps, but yeah, you know, and but yeah, I mean, that's pretty much what it is. I think the easiest thing about it was that we almost feel like we knew each other right from the beginning.
Well, that was kind of our first date, but not
really. Yeah, that was like our first date where we actually met, but our first actual date was, I'll let you finish because you worked there.
We went to my old restaurant, Florentino's, my family is obsessed with.
Eggplant Parmesan.
The best food ever in my book.
Yeah, I disagree.
It,
I don't hate it, I just disagree.
Anyway.
Portions are too small.
We went and had wine and had dinner and then...
Oh my God, yeah.
To be really truthful about it, we went to a strip club. Driving around in the back of the seat and just drove around and was silly. And
we went to a strip club, actually, and met your friend.
Not a friend.
Well, ex-friend.
But...
And we sang Bon Jovi at the top of our lungs,
yeah,
like, all night.
Maniacs, but
yeah.
He was really a gentleman, and he brought me home to my parents' house, and wasn't anything like that.
I bought my first bottle of wine that day too, which is kind of ironic because I sell wine now, so you know. I had no idea. I was one of those people who went to the liquor store and had no idea what Chardonnay or Pinot Grigio was. So I think I bought like a blend of two. It was Luna de Luna.
It was a green bottle.
It was a green bottle. It was like $10.
But our first day was really fun.
Yeah, we had a great time. That's
awesome.
Three.
Husband. No, husband's not an adjective. I can't really use that.
Didn't say it. Just said two words.
Two words. Well, going to be awesome husband.
Two words to describe her. Awesome is one of them because that kind of sums up everything. And the other one, which she don't agree with very often, but I think she's super sexy, so. The funniest thing about her? I just said we were looking over the questions. I think the funniest thing about her is she doesn't think I'm funny, so. The funniest thing about her is probably when she gets worked up, she really gets worked up, and I actually kind of like just sit back and laugh at it. I calm her down so much.
Yeah. You're like a kid, I still have to take care of you, so. I still gotta do laundry and clean up after you, and it's just funny when I just tell you to do the same things over and over again, just never.
Guess
your selective hearing is probably the most hilarious thing. Jason! Like, you're like, what? Like, you're like out of this world.
I only hear what I want to hear, so, you know.
Yeah, it's annoying, but it's kind of funny.
If I hear hot wings, I'm like, okay, where is it? You know. Well, I think we met as friends, so we really were like...
In January?
Yeah, we met in January, and then...
I think by like Memorial Day, May, like that year, that was like when... We really started dating, May. So.
And it took a long time for us to actually say the words, we love each other, but I think we were kind of being safe because instead of just throwing that word around, like, I don't like to say it unless I really mean it, so, you know, but now I say it all the time, so that must mean I really mean it. Yeah. But it's been quite a while before we really knew that. I mean, I think we knew, I think we knew all along, but we didn't want to jinx it kind of thing. We're such good friends that it was hard to, you know, imagine ruining it by putting a label on something. That happened at one of our favorite restaurants, Malaga, in Trenton, a little Spanish restaurant. It was really super nerve-wracking for me because obviously I'd never done it before. And I had bought the ring a couple days before, and it really, I really had it in my mind that I was going to propose before a holiday so that we can go show off our family members the ring and break the news because everyone was going to be together.
It was
so
the day before Thanksgiving.
Yeah, it was the Wednesday before Thanksgiving.
So and November 25th, 2009, and then
that day changes every year. So
I guess the awesome part for me was I came home to I never had a surprise party, and there was this great surprise party in my house when I got home. And I had no idea because I was on the phone with my sister because I couldn't get my parents. So I called my sister and I never even saw one car. I was just oblivious.
Yeah, so. We pulled into the driveway and she still had no idea that there was like 30 cars in the driveway. And then she was just so surprised to walk in the door to all of our friends, and it was cool. I think I did a pretty good job, except for the fact that I didn't get down on one knee. I was like too nervous.
Yeah, that didn't happen.
The dessert came out with the ring in it. It was a pear sorbet. And I really was just like, she looked at it and freaked out and was just like, oh my God, are you kidding me? And I was like, so, will you marry me?
It was
kind of lame.
Perfect number of children. On three, ready?
One, two, three.
Zero.
All right, I'm content with two, but you know,
the third one happens. He wants three boys, I guarantee it, but I don't want any, but I guess we'll compromise at one or two.
One or two, all right. I like that. One, we don't want to have one spoiled brat, so we gotta have at least two.
Maybe two.
not in 38 Robbinsville Edinburgh Road.
Moving out of our house, hopefully.
Hey, we maybe sooner rather than later. Who knows? In 5 years, though, we're gonna be crazy in love still, I hope, and traveling a lot, and maybe thinking about kids. About that time.
That's the timeline.
Maybe a little bit earlier than that, but you know, maybe. I know hers. Eggplant Parmesan from
Florentino's.
Or Chicken Gracia at Frank's.
Oh, no, or?
Or Malaga.
Di Lorenzo's Pizza.
Oh, Di Lorenzo's Pizza. Come on, you're putting trick questions in there. That's not
your
a real meal.
Your favorite food, I guess, this is. Your favorite food is definitely wings and beer, probably.
But where from Wings?
Frank's Wings.
Yeah,
of
yeah,
course.
Yeah,
from Northeast PA Wings.
Any place in Northeast PA.
Any place in Northeast PA can get the wings.
Yeah. Awesome sauce. Yeah. We like a lot of the same stuff. For every difference we have, which is quite a few, we have a similarity. So I think we have got a good balance. You know, I love everything about her.
Take the rain with the sunshine, like we're doing right now.
Yeah, exactly.
Take it as it comes. I'll stress and figure out how to take
it. I think we're very complimentary to one another. Good looking, not so good looking. Yeah.
It truly is.
Somewhere over the rainbow, way up high.